The boy noticed that the man's clothing was strange. He looked like an Arab, which was not unusual in these parts. Africa was only a few hours from Tarifa. One had only to cross the narrow streets of boat. Arabs often appeared in the city, shopping and chanting their strange prayers several times a day.
"Where do you from?"
the boy asked.
"From many places."
"No one can be from many places," the boy said.
"I'm a shepherd, and I have been to many places, but I come from only one place, from a city near an ancient castle. That's where I was born."
"Well, then, we could say that I was born in Salem." The boy didn't know where Salem was, but he didn't want to ask, fearing that he would appear ignorant. He looked at the people in the plaza for a while. They were coming and going, and all of them seemed to be very busy. "So what is Salem like?" he asked, trying to get some sort of clue.
"It's like it always has been."
No clue yet, but he knew that Salem was not in Andalusia. If it were, he would already have heard of it. "And what do you do in Salem?" he insisted.
"What do I do in Salem?"
the old man laughed. "Well, I'm the king of Salem." "People see strange things," the boy thought. "Sometimes it's better to be with the sheep who don't say anything, and better still to be alone with one's books. They tell their incredible stories at the time when you want to hear them. But when you are talking to people, they see some things that are so strange that you don't know how to continue the conversation."
"My name is Melchizedek,"
said the old man.
"How many sheep do you have?"
"Enough," said the boy. He could see that the old man wanted to know more about his life.
"Well, then, we have got a problem. I can't help you if you feel you have got enough sheep."
The boy was getting irritated. He was not asking for help. It was the old man who had asked for a drink of his wine and had started the conversation. "Give me my book," the boy said. "I have to go and gather my sheep and get going."
"Give me 1/10 of your sheep,"
said the old man,
"and I'll tell you how to find the hidden treasure."
The boy remembered his dream, and suddenly everything was clear to him. The old woman had not charged him anything, but the old man, maybe he was her husband, was going to find a way to get much more money in exchange for information about something that did not even exist. The old man was probably a gypsy too. But before the boy could say anything, the old man leaned over, picked up a stick, and began to write in the sand of the plaza. Something bright reflected from his chest with such intensity that the boy was momentarily blinded with a movement that was too quick for someone his age. The man covered whatever it was with his cape. When his vision returned to normal, the boy was able to read what the old man had written in the sand. There, in the sand of plaza of that small city, the boy read the names of his father and his mother and the name of seminary he had attended. He read the name of the merchant's daughter, which he had not even known. And he read things he had never told anyone.
I am the king of Salem, the old man had said. Why would a king be talking with a shepherd? The boy asked, awed and embarrassed.
For several reasons, but let's say that the most important is that you have succeeded in discovering your destiny.
The boy didn't know what a person's destiny was.
It's what you have always wanted to accomplish. Everyone, when they are young, knows what their destiny is. And that point in their lives, everything is clear and everything is possible. They are not afraid to dream and to yearn for everything they would like to see happen to them in their lives. But as time passes, a mysterious force begins to convince them that it'll be impossible for them to realize their destiny.
None of what the old man was saying made much sense to the boy. But he wanted to know what the mysterious force was. The merchant's daughter would be impressed when he told her about that.
It's a force that appears to be negative, but actually shows you how to realize your destiny. It appears your spirit and your will. Because there is one great truth on this planet. Whoever you are, or whatever it is that you do, when you really want something, it's because that desire originated in the soul of the universe. It's your mission on earth. Even when all you want to do is travel? Or marry the daughter of a textile merchant? Yes. Or even search for a treasure? The soul of the world is nourished by people's happiness and also by unhappiness, envy, and jealousy. To realize one's destiny is a person's only real obligation. All things are one. And when you want something, all the universe conspires in helping you to achieve it. They were both silent for a time, observing the plaza and the town people. It was the old man who spoke first. Why do you tend a flock of sheep?
Because I like to travel.